Is everyone, we are Mike and Lauren. If you think about it, nothing life-changing has ever come out of an airplane bathroom. Till now.
Wait till you hear this story after touring wells in hills and valleys.
I've walked among the shadows. You wipe my tears away. And I've felt the pain of heartbreak. And I've seen the brighter days. And I've brought breath to heaven from my lowest place. And I have
got original 1966 Chevrolet C10 pickup truck radio, non-push button. That's what they mainly come with. We've redone the case on this one, redone all the background, repainted the needle. Everything is polished up, cleaned up, the face and all, and push buttons. I mean the control knobs. We've done a full Aurora Design conversion on it. It now has AM/FM stereo, four channels out, 45 watts of channel built in it. It has five pre-outs across the back of it if you want to add an amp to each speaker. Add a sub. It has auxiliary in. We'll demonstrate that. USB port. This is the harness you'll be getting. You can leave it in this or take it out. It'll charge your phone, your devices, and play a thumb drive in here. This is your auxiliary in here, input for it. All that plugs in the radio after you get it in. The push button here is Aurora Design. This is a blue one. This is what the owner wanted. It operates your song changing on your thumb drive, song changing on your phone, answer your phone calls because it has Bluetooth. Voice command, voice assistance, hand-free phone calls, screaming your music, everything all built in the original 66 radio. Right now you're on FM stereo. You have an operating LED here, RGB. It changes multiple colors, whatever the radio is doing. Over here is a little stereo LED, which changes whenever you find a stereo channel. Treble and bass, like you've always had on all AM radios. Now we have four channels. The Aurora Design let us put balance and fader all built into toner control. So if you hook up two speakers, you'll have balance. If you hook up three or four, you'll have balance and fader. And the way it works is we're going to take the toner control and find the center of it. And we're going to go clockwise twice, like a 12 to 2 motion. It's going to beep. When it quits beeping, we're going to be in the fader mode. After you find what you want, as long as you're moving this control, it'll fade from front to rear. When you find what you want, just stop. It'll beep once, and then go back to treble and bass toner control. After that, we're going to go opposite direction, which is a 12 to 10 motion. It's going to do the same thing. It's going to beep, and it's going to put us in the balance mode, right and left. After we set up what we want, stop, it'll beep, and then it'll go back to treble and bass toner control. So go to balance first, fader. Count clockwise. One, two. There's your fronts, there's your rears.
The friendly skies are taking part in Make a Difference Monday.
As long as we're moving this, it will stay there.
Valleys on Air One.
We're going to balance it out and let it beep.
I'm not sure if you heard this amazing story about a flight attendant save a young girl.
Now we're back on treble and bass.
Human trafficking.
Amazing.
So this is what it was.
Her name now we're going to go into the balance control, counterclockwise.
15-year-old girl who's kind of just... this just seems kind of weird. She tried
right,
to talk to her and
left.
Nothing would happen.
She had gut, like that intuition that something is not right.
Exactly. So she went
balance
and
left
in the bathroom for this girl
it,
and then was able to convince her to go and be like, hey, I think
now we got our speakers set up. All we got to worry about is treble and bass.
But it happens all the time. Anyway, once she got
if you don't go to AM radio, just simply turn the unit off and right back on. Little light turns red. AM station.
And have fun while doing it. Whether you're buying your first, I know we had no money.
That's $6.50 in Nashville. Off and right back on, takes you right back to stereo, FM.
And that's just kind of our mantra, and it sounds so.
Now, your auxiliary in, you can plug any device into it you want to, satellite radio, CD players, however you want to configure it up. You'll get a male-to-male harness like this one. You just simply plug it in. Take your device, plug it in, and turn it on. I would help if I fired it up. And the radio is sitting there listening for a device to come in. It will automatically transfer over to auxiliary in. That's a neat deal to have on a radio. That way, if somebody gets your truck, so here you want to listen to this, all you got to do is just plug it in and go straight to it. But when you're done, just turn the device off, and in 20 seconds, the radio will cycle back to where you had it. If you don't want to wait 20 seconds, all you got to do is just simply turn the radio off and right back on. That's during that 20-second shutdown. Now, we've run this in, so we're going to let it do the 20 seconds and make sure everything checks out right.
Yeah, I've been giving you my key. You said you'd be the mess now if it hadn't been for me.
Let's let it cycle, make sure everything's working right. Should be any minute. There it is. Automatically change back over. That's how your auxiliary in device works. Now we're going to do our Bluetooth. Run it in and do the initial pair up. Once you pair your device up, every time you get in the truck, your voice assistant will come on and say device paired. So you shouldn't have to pair it up once unless you're having trouble with your phone like I usually do with this one. We're going to take the Aurora push button and we're going to hold it down.
Ready to pair.
That's her. It showed up on my phone. All I got to do is tap on it. And she would tell me when it's done.
Pairing completed. Device connected.
Alright. Now every time you get in your vehicle and got your phone, she will come on and say device paired. We're going to do a voice command on it. Check that out. We're going to play some music. We're going to hold it down again, just like it was pairing up. Play music. Going to my music on my phone. You have a built-in mic here. And then you have another mic that's going to come with it. That way if you if the truck's a little bit loud or whatever, you can run this mic out of it and put it up closer to you. Shut down the radio and the power, plug in the mic, put it up there. It'll recognize that mic and turn this one off. But I found these mics here to be really, really good. Now, if you want to change your songs in advance, just press it down once. To repeat, hit it twice. Back up, hit it twice. Let's go forward. That's how your voice assistance, voice command works. You bring your phone up, whatever your phone's capable of doing, looking up addresses, finding directions, looking up restaurants, texting. You can bring it up, say text anybody, and it'll come up with that name if you got it listed right, and it'll text for you. Lovely is the summer day. I ain't good enough to do it yet. Anyhow, we're going to use voice assistance. You don't have to. You can just turn it off. It'll go back to your radio just by pressing off on your phone. But we got voice assistance. We're going to use it since we're checking everything out. Stop music. Now it stopped it, and now it's going to go back to radio. That's how your Bluetooth, hand-free phone calls, screaming your music all work. You can work it all with this push button. Now we're going to do the USB. You'll get a USB drive like this one with some music on it, and then you can add your files to it. When you first plug it in, it's going to go straight to it. Same thing, and operate it like you would your phone to advance. Push it down once. Twice to repeat or to back up. Neat thing about this is you don't have to pull this in and out. If you want to, you can leave your thumb drive in there unless you want to charge your device or put more music on it. Because a lot of people like to hide this so you can't see it. You can put it in your glove box. So if you want to go back to radio, just hold this down 1 second. It'll put that in pause. Now we're going to go back to radio. This is going to flash a couple times along with that LED right there in behind it. Now we're back on radio. Going down the road, you want to go to play your music. You ain't got to find your thumb drive. It's already in there. 1 second. Right back to the thumb drive.
Even now in my
we have original bulb in it, so it's got the green tint to it at night, which I like that. I have had people ask for LEDs. If they've changed your lights over to LEDs in your dash, we will try to match it. But the original light, the original bulb is back in this one. Very good sound and clear radio. Let's go back to radio by holding it down 1 second. Put it back in pause, go back to radio. I'm just running sequences on it, checking it out, it's ready to go. Back to where we were at.
Marriage, you perform at work.
Talking to the Viet Cong and the
Mississippi.
That's your original 1966 C10 truck, fully loaded. AM FM stereo auxiliary in. It has Bluetooth, phone call, hand-free phone calls, USB. It's fully loaded. I appreciate you letting me do it for you. Hope you like it. Thank you.